Welcome to our lecture online. Quite often, one of the biggest challenges with mathematics is reading a problem and learning how to interpret it, figuring out what it actually means and how to take the problem and set it up in such a way that we can actually work it out. So here's a good example of that. Here, all we need to do is simply draw out what the problem says, but that's the challenge. Here we have the following sentences. Building B is due west of building A. Building A and B are on street 1. Building D is due north of building A. Building A and D are on street 2. Building C is southwest of building A. Building A and C are on street 3. Building E is due east of building B. And the angle formed by CAE, well, let's see here. Angle CAE formed by streets 1 and 3 is obtuse. So how do we draw out that problem? Well, first of all, we can see that there's going to be three streets. So let's make a note of that. So we have three streets. And how many buildings do we have? We have building A, B, C, D, and E. So 1, 2, 3, that means five buildings. Also, they're giving us some compass directions, so it would be a good idea to put those down. So we have north, south, to the left would be west, and to the right would be east. So we have three streets, five buildings, and our compass directions. Now let's begin by taking each sentence at a time and trying to make sense out of it. First of all, they're telling us that building B is due west of building A. So we have two buildings that are along the east-west line. So let's go ahead and do that. So we have building B to the left and building A to the right. So you can clearly see now that B is due west from building A. So we've satisfied the first sentence. The next sentence says building A and B are on street 1. So we can connect them with a line. I'll move this up a little bit so you can see there. And so this would then be called street 1. So now we have a street, the two buildings. Building B is due west from building A, and together they are on street 1. So now we have the first two taken care of. The next one says that building D is due north of building A. So due north is upward. Here's building A. So we have another building called building D, which is due north from building A. So now we have the third sentence taken care of. Next, it says that building A and D are on street 2, which means we can connect them. We connect those two. We have a second street. We'll call that street 2. That means we have this one taken care of. Next, it says that building C is southwest of building A. Now, southwest would be somewhere in this area right here. So this whole area here would be southwest. Now, where do we put it? That's the question. So let's go ahead and say building C right here. And we need to know somewhere in this area we're going to put building C. So that would be south of A and west of A. So in the southwest corner here. So we're not quite done with that one yet. Next one says that building A and C are on street 3. So now I can connect those two, but again, I don't know which way to connect it. So we'll just leave that for now. The next one says that building E is due east of building B. All right, building E is east of building B. So that would be somewhere along this line right here. So somewhere along this line, we know that we're going to have another building, which is E. And then we know that there's going to be a street that runs kind of like this to build from building A to building C. So again, we're not quite sure what the angle is, and we don't know where on this street right here, on street 1, we find building E. Finally, we now know that the angle CAE must be obtuse, so formed by streets 1 and 3, and that means the angle must be more than 90 degrees. So here's street number 1, Here's street number 3. And do they form an angle that is obtuse, meaning more than 90 degrees? It depends on the perspective. You can see clearly that this angle here would be more than 90 degrees. This angle here would be less than 90 degrees. So it depends which way you want to draw the street. But it doesn't matter in what direction here. So we're going to make this a solid line like this. Here's building C. We can continue the solid line this way. So there is street number 3. Here we have building C. That means building C is southwest of building A. And building A and C are on the same street called street 3. And building E is due east of building B. Now we can put building E anywhere we like as long as it's east of B. So let's go ahead and put it right there. So there's building E. There's no other restrictions to that. And so we've taken care of this. And finally, the angle CAE, so that would be CAE. Oh, now we have a restriction. This angle from CAE must be obtuse. Well, if it must be obtuse, that means E cannot be here. E actually has to be over here, still due east of B, in such a way that CAE, wrong building. So now we see that CAE must be obtuse, so this angle right here must be greater than 90 degrees, which now we can see it is, only if we put E east of A, not between A and B. If we put E between A and B, it would satisfy this condition right here, but it would not satisfy the final condition where the angle from C to A to E must be greater than 90 degrees, and so now we've taken care of it all. So you can see that is often the hardest part of doing any kind of problem. It's reading what the problem says and trying to interpret, or trying to find a way to interpret it and interpret in such a way that we can have a visual picture of what the problem is telling us. So I believe now we've taken care of it all and all the statements are satisfied with the way we've drawn it here. And that's how it's done.